program of the training course Genomics of Agriculturally Important Insects. The end of the story is the new beginning for many others. On this note, let's have a documentary on the remarkable journey of this knowledgeable event. Documentary, please. thank you, Mogli Ramayya and team, for taking us down to your memory lane. Let's start the today's session by inviting our guest, Anda Dias. May I request Dr. A.K. Singh sir, DDG Extension ICR and Director IARI, and Dr. Rashmi Agarwal ma'am, Dean and Joint Director Education, Dr. C. Vishwanathan sir, PI, CAST, ICR, IARI, Dr. Manjaya, Associate Dean and Nodal Officer for CAST, and Dr. R.K. Sharma sir, Head Division of Entomology, and finally, Dr. Subramaniam sir, Course Director. Thanks to all the dignitaries. Now, may I request Dr. C. Vishwanathan sir, PI, CAST, ICR, IARI, to give welcome address and brief about the training program.
Good afternoon to all of you. I welcome our Honorable Director IARI and Deputy Director General Extension ICR. I request Dr. Sharma to welcome our director with the plant. Sir, we are very grateful for your sparing your valuable time and for coming to this training program. To felicitate the students who have successfully completed the training program. Sir, you have always taken keen interest in the training program and you give unconditional support, and because of your support we could take up this training program, and this is the third training program which is to be completed today. I welcome our Dean, Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, for this valedictory function. And on the inaugural day also, Madam was ready to come, but because of some urgent emergency work, she could not attend that training program. But today she has come. And for all the training program, Madam has kindly come for the inaugural and valedictory program and gives her support. I welcome Madam with the plans. I also welcome Dr. Manjaya, Nodal Officer CAST. He provides all the logistic support and takes a keen interest in the conduct of training. I request Dr. Sharma to welcome Dr. Manjaya with the plan. So then I also welcome the host, Dr. Sharma, for being here, and because of his support and coordination, the training program was a big success. I welcome him. And then I welcome Dr. Subramaniam, the course director, and Dr. Sagar, and other dignitaries, Dr. A. Kumar, and Dr. Subhas, and Dr. Kalia Madam, she was there, and Dr. Deepa, and all the faculty members who has contributed to this training, and also the CAST core team member and associate team member who could able to come to this program, and some of them could not come because of other urgent engagement. Sir, this is the third training program in the series of genomic assisted crop improvement and management. As we know that for last 20 years, the genomics program is moving fast, and after 2000 with the discovery of next generation sequencing, now generating sequence information for any organism is very easy now. And already, as in the inaugural address, our joint director research told about 1,219 insect genome sequencing project have been registered with the National Center for Biotechnology Information System. So these sequence projects, they generate sequences containing ATGC only. So we have to decipher the information from the sequence to use it for either the pest management or for enhancing the productivity of beneficial organism, either it may be like honeybee or the insect vector species. So for all this, we need the sequence information has to be understood and it needs to be used. We know that the decadal vision for this for next 15 years is to understand the ability to predict trait from the sequence information. So if you want to do that, we should know all the techniques that are used in the genomics. So towards this, sir, this is the TRAD training program organized, and we got overwhelming response from students, and about the detailed training report will be given by Dr. Subramaniam, the ABLE course director. So with this brief word, I welcome all the dignitaries and specifically all the students. Although formal vote of thanks will be there, but I once again I welcome all the students for sparing their valuable time and spent the useful time here, and I hope the training program was very useful. Thank you, Anish.
Thank you, Vishwanathan sir, for welcoming our dignitaries and briefing about the CAST training program. May I request Dr. S. Subramaniam sir to provide a brief note on training program.
Good afternoon to all, respected director, respected dean, respected head of the division, PA of this program, Dr. Vishwanathan, associate dean, Dr. Manjaya, faculty members of our division and other division, and the staff members who train these students for this training program, and foremost important, the trainees, without whom this training would not have been completed this much successfully, I can say. A brief introduction, Director sir, about this training. Around about 135 candidates across India have applied for this training program. So it made possible to select candidates across the states. So now we have the students selected from 16 universities, one deemed agriculture university and one central agriculture university. They are drawn from 16 states of India, starting from Kashmir to Tamil Nadu then, and Gujarat to Assam in the east. So it's an overwhelming support, and it shows the enthusiasm by the students on the cutting edge technologies of genomics. Sir, it's an era of even insect pest management guided by the genomics. Worldwide, the insect pest management is redefined by the use of molecular biological tools, especially even IPM. There is a new section called IPM Bomics. There are genomic information is helpful in designing the new pheromone molecule. Likewise, in many cases, the genomic information gives a new target site for novel pesticides. So the scope is endless. It is our duty, especially to capacitate our young generation on these cutting edge technologies. At this juncture, the funding by the NIHP, ICR, and the CAST program of the IRA have come in handy. With this program, it is possible to give a hands-on training to the students. We have conducted as a 10-day training, sir. In this, we have covered nearly 19 lectures and about equally around 10 to 15 practicals. In some cases, we have given optional practicals. Some students are interested in taxonomy. They have some specifically designed program on that. And in some section, they want for biological control. Sir, we have the flexibility in practical also. Besides, we made arrangements for visit to the phenomics facility and ISRI and the genomics center in there. The trainees were taught by the faculty members of our division with the able support of our professor of the division. All the faculty members have contributed to this. Besides, we have the staff members from the microbiology division, plant pathology division, and NPIB, and besides scientists from the Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, NBIR, Tamil Nadu Agriculture University Research, all have acted as an able resource person in guiding the students, especially on the recent developments in genomics, how it can be best used with both theory and practical exposure. Regarding the performance of the student, that is really a factor. It can tell about how they have improved during this training program. In the pre-training, the score range was 1 to 22 out of 30 marks. That is their score range. Whereas in the post-training evaluation, they have performed overwhelmingly, all based on our training manual materials only. The score range was starting from 22 to 30. Four students have scored 30 out of 30, and about 8 students have scored about 28, 5 and 29 range. If we take the student's performance with a mean value of 25 as a median value, nearly 80 or 70% of the students have far above. In others also, they have learned the practical nuggets of the training. That is more heartening. And this may help the students in better designing their research program, as well as it helps them to improve their thesis work, I hope. With these words, I thank you all for giving me the opportunity. And I sincerely thank the trainees who have keenly participated both in the theory and practical portion of the training.
Webinar.
And besides this, an added information is we have every day passing on this web link to the, through the students. They have one, we have formed a WhatsApp group. There is a training of them. And these students, in turn, they have been transmitting this web link to their institutes. They are viewing it. And we are also transferring to the entomologist WhatsApp group and also to the different agricultural institutes. We got overwhelming support from the faculty members of the Madurai Agriculture College, Kilikudam, and main campus of Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. They made arrangements for viewing these lectures throughout the training program, and they also shared their photos. And every day, it's seen by the, in the beginning, it was around 50 to 80 students have been following this training program. And at the, during the course of the training, some of these lectures have been live. It was viewed by around somewhere 300 to 400 students at a time. It shows their active involvement across the state. Even many might not have shared the photos. I'm sure this, the host institute of the trainees, they also viewed and benefited of this training program, I hope. Thank you, sir.
For the brief report. Now it's time to take opinion and feedback from our student trainees. I request trainees to come over voluntarily and share few words about your training program. Please.
So a pleasant good afternoon to one and all on the dais and off the dais and all my trainees and one and all present in this hall. First of all, I would like to say a big thanks to NAHEP, the World Bank ICR funded and CAST for organizing this excellent program on genomics of agriculturally important insects. Whatever I had learned, it was a great helpful for my for me to carrying out in my research in future. So I will take a part by part and I will say my feedback in that. So first I would like to mention about the lecture part. In this lecture part, the people from different faculties, the persons who have given the lecture, they have given elaborately and in excellent manner from their part where they belongs to. Special mentions to the plant pathology people and biotechnology people, they have done an excellent job in this lecture. Even though being an ordinary man, many things went inside my mind. I felt something which was quite difficult to understand. But it is not a problem because whenever I need to carry out that problem, I want to get back again, I can go with the live telecast program in YouTube and I can get it back. Really, it was an awesome part of this program. So I thank this organizer for making this excellent video telecasting program. So next part is practical. Even though the lecture was very much informative and innovative, but the practical part was one step higher than this lecture because the learning by doing was really a good experience. In this case of practical, I would like to give a special mention to the people, I think they may not be here, Ms. Subham, Rahul, Rajna ma'am, those who have helped us in teaching and handling the tools and respected to the molecular aspects. And also, one student, I forget her name, she is a student of Andy Kumar sir for teaching us excellently about the QRT-PCR and also in practical aspect, I would like to mention that Anirban Roy sir. Because he has been here for afternoon up to evening 6:30. That is 6:30. When we are reaching the hostel, it is up to, nearly it is 7. He has spent the valuable time with us and teaching us like a children in a step-by-step manner. That was really awesome, sir. And besides that, all the part of this staff members and some other staff like Darish Mishram, sir, and Shashank, sir, and Vinay Kalyan, ma'am, and I forget some of their names actually. I would like to mention all of them from this IRA division has given an excellent lecture other than the program which is already scheduled here. Especially that Sashank sir has taken me to the PUSA collection. He has explained me in nice manner even after 5:30 p.m. So thank you so much, sir. So next in the in case of that course organizers and course coordinator part, first that course coordinator Sagar sir, I think this program has been running for the past 10 days, but Sagar has just taken this before 15 days of the start of this training, because he was all the time he was communicating has been through email daily. He is giving mail and WhatsApp, his daily messaging, and you should be ready and you should be come along with this. Thank you so much sir for being with us for the past 1 month actually. So his kind of attitude is entirely like a friendly attitude. Next, then another then our course director, our beloved Subramani sir. Even though that Sagar sir has showed a friendly attitude towards us, that Subramani sir has one step higher. He has showed that just like a guardian, I think even none of our many of our trainees may not be know, because after reaching the hostel, we will go out and roam the Delhi. But what Subramani sir will do means, after we are reaching there, he will come there. And he will stay with us for 1 hour, and he will spend his valuable time like asking whether everything is okay for you, the food and accommodation, is everything okay for you. Sir, that shows your lovely attitude with us. Really, thank you so much, sir. Whatever the food and accommodation you have provided is really excellent, whatever they may be. But you have made it us as a joint family, because we 25 people at a place, it is really nice for accommodating all of us in a single place. Thank you so much, sir. So up next, I would like to thank my co-trainees. Really, I had a nice time with them. Actually, this is my first time to Delhi. I just went outside many places with that Sachin, Gangaraju sir, Swayam sir, and my senior beloved Tamil Nagam sir for taking me out, and for just we went and we went many places in Delhi. That was really a very good opportunity. And this live telecast, my people has instructed me to mention there, because in my campus TNAU they have live telecasted every day. The people from there has viewed the program, and they said many lectures was really awesome. So on behalf of them, I would also like to thank with all the organizers for providing this wonderful opportunity. There is one quote: an excellent teacher only inspires the student. So we are the inspirers and you are the excellent teachers. Thank you sir for providing this best opportunity.
The overwhelming feedback. Now from the girl side, anyone? Good afternoon to one and all. First of all, I would like to thank World Bank funded NAIEB CAST in collaboration with the IRI, and Subramanian sir, Sagar sir, and Rajana madam, since from 10 days, they worked like anything, like regarding practical classes or theory classes. They prior only they used to inform us. And regarding my research, I am very much afraid of my research program, since I have molecular techniques to identify the root groups and also diversity studies in case of Metrizium anisophiliae. But after coming here, I learned many techniques regarding molecular aspects that may help in my research program. After going to my place, I will definitely conduct the research program excellently, because of so many theory classes conducted in this training program. And most of the classes were very nice. Among those, I am very much like molecular phylogeny, principles and practices by Anirban Roy, IRI, New Delhi, both practicals and theory. It was excellent. That day we were up to 6:30. Both the classes are very nice, and we learned many bioinformatic techniques. And coming to the next one is DNA barcoding by Venkateshan sir, NBIR, Bangalore. His class was excellent, and what exactly students wants, that only he mentioned in his class. That was an excellent class for me. And Naresh Meshram, IRI, New Delhi, from Division of Entomology, he mentioned about morphotaxonomy. If we are failing to identify through morphotaxonomy, at last please prefer the molecular tool in order to identify the different insect species. This was he told. Such an excellent teacher he is. And molecular markers for entomological research by Mohan Kumar sir.
That lecture is very nice by Mohan Kumar sir. And regarding practical classes, we learned qPCR, PCR technique, RFLP PCR for entomological, different entomological approaches. And it is among the 35 peoples from the Karnataka, we three have been selected, myself and Gangaraju and Ranjita. We are very much fortunate to attend this training program. And thanks to all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Soumya, for your valuable feedback. Now, may I request Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, ma'am, Dean, Joint Director of Education, to give brief remark on the training program. Ma'am, please.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable Director of the Institute, Dr. A.K. Singh, our PI of the project, Dr. Vishwanathan, Course Director, Dr. Subramanyam, then we have Head of the Division on the Dais, Dr. R.K. Sharma, and Associate Dean, Dr. Manjaya. A very warm welcome to all of you on this valedictory function. As mentioned by earlier speakers, that we have students from 17 different universities covering 16 different states. And it's a very happy occasion that we have students from extreme north, Jammu and Kashmir, till Tamil Nadu or Kanyakumari. So it's a very, and from west to east. So 25 students representing many different states, and they are the fertile minds of the country. So the topic of this training program was genomics of agriculturally important insects, which is the third training program in the series under this NAHEP program. All of you already have heard much about NAHEP. It's a very ambitious program. Under CAST, we are training the students, and we are also sending the students abroad for the short and long-term training programs. So I must say the students, you people are very lucky to have been selected for this training program. And this was a roughly 12 days training program, and as mentioned by the students themselves, that they have really been, they have learned so much, and they have been inspired by the motivating faculty of IRI. So it's a very happy occasion for me as head of the Division of Plant Pathology and also as a dean that our faculty is so well imparting the education and practical training program, not only to the faculty, because we also have CAFT programs running in IRI, but also to the students. So because NAHEP is basically student-oriented program, so the listening from the students' mouth was really very, very fascinating, and it's a pleasure for me that you have learned a lot under this training program, and definitely you will go back, and some of you, may not be all of you, but at least 60-70% of the students will take up these learned procedures, tools, and techniques, and you will really use them in your PhD programs. As very rightly mentioned, that you have been trained in the genomics of insects. Just simply getting the sequence of any organism is not sufficient. It doesn't end here. You have to really utilize that sequence for some useful purposes. And for pest and disease management, you know how much utility we have for the genome sequence of any pathogen or pest in your case. So that information, if you can utilize, you can functionally validate, take out some important genes, or fish out some important markers which you can utilize for looking for the resistance, or in insects or in the pathogens, how you can silence some of the genes which are related to the pathogenicity or infection process, will be really very useful. So at this age, tender age, when you are entering into your final degree program, your brains are very fertile. So you can take up the message and do good work under PhD program, and then when you become scientist, you can always will cherish, and you will be really very happy and thankful that this training program was given at the right stage in your whole career. So once again, I forgot to address some of the faculty programs. I see Dr. Kumar, Dr. Subhashandra, core members and also the associate member of this NAHEP program, and faculty of entomology. Because this program was entomology oriented, so I see many of the faculty members are here, very learned, who have undertaken theory and practical classes. So with this, under this ambitious program, We are very happy that we have finished 3 training programs, and many more programs are in the pipeline. And also, it's a very satisfying point that all these lectures were webcasted. I have also seen many of the lectures webcasted on YouTube, and also a plant protection group is there where we have entomologists, nematologists, pathologists, and many other crop protectionists. So I saw there also all the were directly telecast programs were there, and still now also, as one of the students mentioned, you can go back, and if you are not able to understand something, you can go back again, look into those presentations in YouTube. So with these words, I congratulate all of you. And because of you only, we are able to get successfully this training program conducted. And all the best wishes for your future programs. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable remarks. Now, it's time to reward our vibrant students with the certificate. May I request Director IARI for the certificate distribution? I request students to come one after the other after my announcement. Kavita Bajaj. Next, Atitya. After Atitya, Adrish Day. Anushree, Kerala Agriculture University, Vellayani, Kerala. After Anushree, Mohan Ganesh, AAU, Assam. Gangaraju P, University of Agricultural Science, Dharwad. K Ashok, TNAU, Coimbatore. Jatin, Gwalior, Madhya Pradesh. Kartik R, Umiyam, Meghalaya. Masrat, Jammu and Kashmir. Mm-hmm.
Delhi.
Ramya Shri, PGT SAU, Hyderabad, Telangana. Ramana Angru, Bapatla. Naveen Rao, CCS HAU, Hisar, Haryana. Naganna, JAU, Junagadh, Gujarat. Radhesham Ramakrishna, BHU, Varanasi. Ranjita, Agriculture College, Bijapur, University of Agricultural Science, Dharwad. Sachin G, Kerala Agricultural University, Thrissur, Kerala. Prashanti, SV Agriculture College, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh. Soumya E, University of Agriculture Sciences, Raichur, Karnataka. Sudishna, Punjab Agriculture University, Ludhiana, Punjab. Swayam Singh, G.B. Pant Agriculture University, Pantnagar, Uttarakhand. Tamil Nayagam, TNAU, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. Srihari, PDKV, Akola, Maharashtra. Thank you, dignitaries, for issuing certificates to our student. Now, a leader is someone who creates an event. Team member essentially brings life to it. Now it's time to reward one such leader, that is R. Subramaniam sir. May I request Director IRA to give memento to Dr. S. Subramaniam sir, course director, as a mark of memory. Momento 2, Dr. Sagar, course coordinator. Thank you, sir, and thank you, everyone. We are at the flag end of the program. May I request Dr. A.K. Singh, sir, DDG Extension ICAR and Director IARI to give valedictory address.
Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, Dean IARI, Dr. Vishwanathan, PI of this project and head of the division, Division of Physiology, Dr. R.K. Sharma, head of the division, Physiology, Dr. Manjaya, Associate Dean, Dr. Subramanian and Dr. Sagar, and other faculty members who are sitting here and dear students. I congratulate all of you who have got the certificates today. And I'm very happy that you had a lot of appreciation for the course directors, both of them. And that is one indicator for the success of any program. The kind of care you have got from them and the support which is required once you come out of your homes to a distant place and you find the environment is new and someone comes to you to help. So that is one thing, and I also find that once you come for a training program like this, you develop relationships which last quite long. At your campuses itself, you have got friends. But once you come to a place and you are living together for 10 days, the bondings are altogether different. So I think you will cherish many of the relationships which you have developed for lifelong also. This course is also important. I find that representation is from as much of university as much it can. Almost 16 universities coming to being represented, the states being represented. And right from across the country, the students have come up. Probably that is the purpose. Once I was discussing with Dr. Manjaya, I said that representation has to be from all parts of the country. So I find faces from different parts, and that's the one success I will attribute to this program. The other success is that it is being seen at different places. The lectures which is being delivered here, and it has to be further popularized. It's maybe somewhere people are more aware, somewhere people are not more aware, not very keen to learn also, you will find many campuses. And when we talk of some advanced courses, people will try to run away instead of coming forward and learning those courses. So there also we need to motivate the students and also the faculty. Even faculty also, see, if advanced courses are taking place, the faculty from other universities which are not attuned with all the advanced courses, they can also join this program through WebLink. Not directly coming, but at least they can join. And if you offer also some of the faculty, if they are willing to come under NHEP and get the training here, maybe a joint group of students and faculty or a separate group of faculty you can have, probably that will give a different kinds of, because IRI has got all kinds of orientation. They have got the facility, they have got the labs, they have got the scientists who are having caliber to teach to any part of the world. So that is one advantage which is there at this campus, and that can be availed by other institutions. And how it can be on a regular basis, that we have to look into. Enhancing our own capacity and also enhancing the capacity of the universities and also the students who are there. Now the other platform which have IRI opened just, I think, this year itself, that for 1 month training, students can get attached to different labs. And probably we are charging also for that, ₹10,000 or so. Students are applying this year, I think a batch of 30 got trained that one. I think these opportunities were not there earlier. When we studied, there was no opportunity for any training for the students. Training used to be only for the faculty members, not for the students. But recently it has been started, and you have got the advantage in off times when your university is closed, maybe during June and others, you can come to IRI campus. And online, every time you can go to our library also. And many of the lectures you will find it is already on the YouTube. We also used to have very, you can say, topical lectures by very senior scientists in the country. Yesterday itself, we had one on artificial intelligence by Director IIT Jodhpur. So such lectures are very important, and I hope that you continue to learn. See, there is no answer to learning. It cannot be a better friend than learning. You keep on learning whenever you get an opportunity. Probably that is the path for the success. And that is why I find many of our colleagues who are here at IRI, they have been all the life learning. Even I find very senior persons who are retired, they come and they try to learn here. If some new labs are getting established, they come, they see, they learn. And once they learn, they narrate the whole story and explain it at different platforms, that how it is happening, how science is developing. The advantage at this campus is that it's exposed to different embassies, different countries, the experts, scientists, students used to come here, and we get the knowledge from them also. It's not that only IRI gives the knowledge, but IRI gains from the visits of the foreign delegations, and we are enhancing our capability accordingly. We go and see across globe that what kind of facilities they have. And by that only we have been able to establish one phenomics kind of facility. And this facility has to be utilized by all divisions. It's not that it is meant for only physiology or genetics, but it has to be utilized by others also. We are trying to find the genetic potential against different stresses, and for that we need all to join together. It's not a one discipline effort, but efforts have to be integrated in nature all the time. And if you look into that way, probably we as an student, we as a faculty can be more successful. Now we are, through this platform again, we are trying to have certain MOOCs. You might be knowing massive online open courses. It is being run in different disciplines, but we wish that 2-3 MOOCs we start very quickly, so that those who are not coming also, they can come and they register on MOOCs, they can learn from MOOCs on daily basis, and also they can appear for evaluation on MOOCs. And certificates can be issued by IRI, need not to come to IRI. So probably that platform, if we start doing through NIHAP, and probably we will be a kind of institution in agriculture who can pioneer basically to educate students sitting at different places. And it can be for different kinds of groups, maybe for extension officials, maybe for the industry people, and maybe for the students also. So, and even for faculty members, those who are newly joining different places, they can join these MOOCs. And they can get all kinds of knowledge updated time and again. They can get the certificates from IRI, and they can start different kinds of research programs. These learnings which have been given to you under this program, basically it's meant that your capability in the research area is enhanced. And how much of you are going to be interested in research in your future, probably that will make a kind of decision that how much you are contributing to the society in the field of genomics in entomology, which Dr. R.K. Sharma has been pursuing throughout his life. Many of you will go to different other services also, but learnings always come to your rescue wherever you are. Even in administration, I find many gets later on their jobs in the agriculture ministries, and then their learnings have been all very much utilized there. So keep on learning, that is what I will wish here. Keep yourself connected with the institutions. Keep yourself connected with the libraries, with the labs, and with the scientists. Most importantly, you must have gurus in your life, throughout your life, which could mentor you all the time. wherever you are, wherever you need, wherever you seek the blessings from your teachers, you should create a kind of bond which is required to get success. Ultimately, you need to have relations, you need to love people and love your country. That is what we have been always pursuing. And for that you need to basically keep yourself always updated and concerned to the task. I will congratulate each one of you once more, and I hope that wherever you are going in your future career, you will be able to contribute to the society. You are known in the society, and for that you will continue to aspire. Thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you, sir, for your valedictory address. May I request Dr. R.K. Sharma, sir, Head, Division of Entomology, to felicitate Dr. A.K. Singh, sir. Thank you, Sharma sir, for felicitating our beloved director. Now, may I request Dr. Sagar D, coordinator, to extend his vote of thanks. Sorry. Sir, I also request you to felicitate Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, ma'am. Thank you, sir, for felicitating our dean. Now, may I request Dr. Sagar D, coordinator, to extend his vote of thanks.
Respected director, sir, dean and joint director, education, Rashmi Madam, PI caste and head division of physiology division, Dr. Vishwanathan, sir, head entomology, Dr. R.K. Sharma, sir, associate dean, Manjay, sir, and dear senior and fellow colleagues from different divisions of plant pathology, different divisions like plant pathology, microbiology, biochemistry, and from our own division, and student trainees, and ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to one and all present over here. It gives me a great honor and privilege for me to propose a formal vote of thanks on the occasion of valedictory function of NHGP CAS sponsored training on genomics of agriculturally important insects organized by Division of Entomology. When we invited Director Sir, he was preoccupied with some other important assignments, but he made a point that he will come for the valedictory function. He is here and he graced the occasion and he has motivated the students. Thank you so much for your presence, sir. I am also thankful to Dean and Joint Director Education, Dr. Rashmi Madam, for all the support and encouragement which is given by you for throughout the training program. And I am especially thankful to you for giving this and permitting us to conduct this training in the very beautiful auditorium of this plant pathology division. My heartfelt thanks to Vishwanathan sir, Manjay sir, for guiding us in each and every step of execution of this training program, even in planning of all the activities, including inaugural, valedictory, day-to-day activities. They were guiding like mentors. Thank you so much, sir, for both of you. I am greatly indebted to our head at Division of Entomology, Dr. R.K. Sharma, sir, who was with us all the time. I am highly thankful for his constant help and support. I am highly thankful to our beloved course director, Dr. S. Subramaniam, sir, for his meticulous planning of lectures, or whenever there were no resource persons, he was swapping and he was making arrangements that for all the lectures. Thank you so much, sir. I also extend my acknowledgements and gratitude to ICR, NHGP director, coordinator, CAST team of IRI, especially Dr. A. Kumar, sir, core team members, and other members of the core team member of CAST. Special thanks to all the resource persons from IRI, like different divisions like biochemistry, plant pathology, microbiology, entomology, plant physiology, and the sister institutes in the POSA campus like NIPB and other ICR institutes, IIHR, ISRI, NBIR, and TNAU, who have enlightened the trainees regarding the genomics in general and insulin genomics and molecular biology in particular. I need to mention few names without which, without whom the this training would have not been possible. My special thanks to Rajna, Timanna and Bhagyashree, scientists of our division, the project staff Rahul, Shubham, Dev, and students Ranjit, Ramesh, Richie, Chidanan, without which, without them, this training would not have been possible. My special thanks to Chandra Kishore, who is taking care of this auditorium every day. He was coming and opening on time. My heartfelt gratitude to PDWTC, Dr. Man Singh sir, who has permitted or provided the bus for pick and drop of the students. I extend my special thanks to trainees from whom this training was successful. Thank you, dear students, for your interest as well as punctuality, sincerity. My sincere request is to continue practicing whatever the techniques learned here. You should carry forward. You should become ambassadors of IRI. I am also thankful to the Movie World who have live streamed all the lectures. I am thankful to all those who have responded to our invitation and they have attended this training, this closing ceremony of training. I am also thankful to AKMU for providing all the facilities related to internet. I am also thankful to the former guest house in charge, Dr. Barman sir and Bharadwaj sir, for accommodating our trainees in the guest house. If I would have missed any name, I pardon me. At the last, I can say one thing. Thank you one and all for those who are directly, indirectly supported in execution of this training program. Thank you one and all. Now I request for a group photo outside the auditorium. After that, we'll join for a high tea.